Hi everyone, this is Peric from P2 Design. In this video, I will show you how I've created the custom sky shader for my latest animation. It was the most requested tutorial after I've published the stylized VFX video. Don't hesitate to check out the other teaser video and their associated tutorials. As usual, you will find the link in the description below. Let's get started. The first thing we need to do is go to our preferences, go to the add-on and make sure that the Node Wrangler add-on is enabled. We will be using the real-time render engine Eevee and we can get rid of everything in our scene and press Shift A and add a plane and scale it. This is going to be our ground. Once it's scaled, I will press Ctrl A to apply the scale. I will quickly rename it ground and I will add a new material to it that I will call ground 2. I will make this material pretty dark and I will reduce its specularity so that we don't have refractions. This is not a very important step, it's just to have a point of reference whenever we are going to work on our sky. So we can now expand a bit the timeline and switch to the shader editor and open the world editing tab. We already have by default a world material and this is what we can see in the background. If I get rid of the overlay, we can see this gray background, and if I change the color of the world node, we can see the background changing color. To see all this, make sure that you are in rendered mode. Here is the final node setup we are going to create. You can make a screen capture of it. Now, let's select our background node and press Ctrl T. This will automatically add an environment texture with all the texture coordinates node setup we need. The background turned to pink to signify us that Blender didn't find any texture. We won't be using an environment texture, so I can get rid of this node and then press Shift A, go to texture and add a gradient texture node. Plug the mapping into the vector input and plug the coloring output into the background color. If we now orbit into our scene and re-enable the overlay, we can see that the gradient is cutting our scene vertically while we'd like to have an horizontal gradient. The idea is to build a color variation between the horizon and the zenith of our sky. So we need to rotate the gradient by 90 degrees on the y-axis. From there, we can simply add a converter color ramp and plug it between the gradient texture and the background input. From there, it's a good point to search for some sky references to create your gradient. In my case, I knew what I wanted and I wanted to blend the ground with the zenith. So I would make the horizon a little darker and the zenith a little lighter. We will now build some clouds. To do so, we will simply mix two noise textures. I will select the mapping node and press Ctrl Shift D to duplicate it and keep it plugged to the generated coordinates. I will then reset the rotation value to 0. Then I will press Shift A, go to texture and add a noise texture. We can now plug our mapping output to this noise texture. If we now Ctrl Shift left click the noise texture, thanks to the Node Wrangler add-on, we can see the result. And we get a basic noise texture all around our sky texture. You can add a converter color ramp to contrast a bit the noise texture and better see it. From there, we will play with the mapping node and the scale of the texture. Instead of having an homogeneous noise, we will stretch it on the horizon. To do so, we can whether play with the X and Y scale or play with the Z scale and squash the noise texture. As we increase the Z scale of the texture, we can see the noise kind of stretch along the horizon. If you play with the Y scale of the texture, we can see it being stretched along the Y axis. So it's not homogeneous along the whole horizon. It's aligned with the world space coordinates. To make things simpler, just think of the world as a simple sphere. If you modify its y scale, you will stretch it along one axis. And you would also need to play with the x scale to get an homogeneous horizon. While if you play only with the z coordinate, you will be able to squash the clouds. Then you can consider the scale of the noise texture as being a factor of the scale of the mapping node. What it means is that we can use a single mapping node with a specific value to drive different noise texture with their own scale. In this specific case, I've set the mapping node scale on Z to 20 and the noise texture scale to 0.8. Now, to create a bit of variation, I will simply duplicate our noise texture, pressing Ctrl+Shift+D to keep it plugged. And to mix those two noise texture, I will press Shift+A and add a color mix RGB. I will change the scale of the second noise texture to 0.3, for example, and we will plug each noise texture factor into the color input of the mix RGB node. We can then plug the result into the color ramp, and we will switch the mix mode to multiply. I will then push the factor to 0.9, and now we can play with the color ramp to get different clouds size. By mixing those two noise texture with different scale, we create a more complex pattern with big shapes cut by smaller shapes. And by default, the generated coordinates give us this nice spiraling pattern. Now that we have our cloud base pattern, let's give it a bit of color. As for the sky, it will be great to have a color variation based on the altitude, so we can reuse our gradient texture by mixing it with our noise texture. So I will press Shift+A, go to color and add a new mix color. We can plug our color ramp from our noise texture in the bottom socket and our gradient in the first socket, and switch the mix mode to soft light. I can Ctrl+Shift+click it to see the result and push the mix factor to 1. We can now see a nice gradient that goes from black on the horizon to a lighter noise on the zenith. From there, I will add a new color ramp just after our mix RGB node. We can duplicate an existing color ramp, and I will give colors to those clouds. I will use color tones that will be close to what we have for our sky color, but I will make them slightly darker. We now still have exactly the same cloud pattern we have created before, but now they have a nice color that will fit with our sky color. If you want to clean a bit your node setup, you can press Shift+A, go to Layout and add a reroute node. It's a simple point that will allow you to create corners into your node's setup. It has absolutely no impact on the way nodes work, it will just help your visual organization. This tutorial is sponsored by myself. If you want to learn all my rigging technique, or if you want to create stylized character from scratch, you will find all you need on my Gumroad page. Use the code P2Design and get 10% on whatever product you want. The final step is now to blend our sky color with our cloud color. So in the end, we just need to add a color mix RGB and plug both our gradient into the color input of the node. And then plug the output of the mix color into the input of our background. If we now play with the factor of the mix RGB node, we can switch to whether see the sky color or our cloud color. And to do it with an interesting pattern, I will simply press Ctrl+Shift+D to duplicate our cloud noise, and we will use it as the factor to mix the sky and the clouds. If we now play with the contrast of this color ramp, we can see more or less cloud appearing in our sky. but we don't get this kind of stylized effect. And most of this kind of 2D effect comes from the fact that I switched the blending mode of the color ramp from linear to constant interpolation. Before we start tweaking the color ramp value, we need to make sure that the cloud output is in the first socket of the mix color and the sky output is in the second socket, so that I can push the black flag to the left, and now whatever is white will be our sky. So by moving the white flag of the second color ramp, I can choose the size of the different clouds. Once I'm happy with the result, I will add a couple of reroutes so that I can get a cleaner node setup. And then we will input a bit of animation into the rotation coordinates of the mapping node so that we can animate those clouds. If we use the Z rotation axis to rotate our texture, it will simply rotate around the zenith. But if we rotate around X or Y, we will have some kind of evolution in the texture. There are other ways to make a texture evolve in time using advanced noise options. But for the sake of this tutorial, that's way enough, and this is how I did it for my animation. So I will open the timeline. I will hover over the rotation values, press I to insert a keyframe, go on to frame 20, insert a value of 1 on the X rotation and press I again. Now I will switch my timeline to the graph editor. I will expose the different transform channel on the left panel by clicking the down arrow. And since we are not animating the X and Z value, I will get rid of them. Now I will select my X curve, you can press A to do so, then press T and switch it to linear interpolation. And then to make sure that the animation goes over time, I will press Shift E and choose linear extrapolation. Now Blender will automatically extrapolate the X rotation value and we can play with the scale of this value in the graph editor to make the rotation or the evolution of our cloud slower or faster. And now our custom stylized sky is done. I hope you've enjoyed this video. This is the end of the tutorial and I will see you in the next one.